Breathing efficiency. There is a cost of breathing. The harder you breathe, the more of your oxygen goes to support your breathing muscles. So hypernea, which is the increased depth of breathing, it increases. Because you have to think of it this way, your diaphragm, your intercostals, they need oxygen. If you're really working them hard, they're going to need more oxygen. And they're also prone to fatigue. 50% of athletes are prone to diaphragmatic fatigue. If the diaphragm fatigues, blood is stolen from the legs to feed the diaphragm. But then the athlete has to cease. So every part of the body in sports is being trained except the diaphragm. Moderate physical exercise, the cost of the respiratory system is 3 to 6% of your total VO2 max. So the consumption of oxygen by your respiratory muscles is 3 to 6% during moderate exercise. It's about 10% during heavy exercise, and with maximal physical exercise is 13 to 15%. That's quite a high oxygen consumption, that your breathing muscles are consuming a lot of oxygen there, which could otherwise be distributed to your working muscles. Breathing efficiency and physical fitness are both independent and complementary. My point here is that we see many athletes, they're physically fit, but they don't have efficient breathing. You can be physically fit with poor breathing. Physical fitness doesn't train your breathing, but breathing efficiency will train your fitness. So your breathing efficiency will feed into your fitness levels, but your fitness levels don't necessarily feed back into your breathing efficiency. So we should be breathing, it should be light, quiet, gentle, through the nose, and using the diaphragm. That's how we would have breathed until modern life changed many things. This is Sonia Ross Richards. She's in full flight, mouth closed. And I have a second photograph of her later on. And we've looked at some of these Kenyan runners. Now, you notice a couple of things. You look at her jaw structure. It's pretty good, isn't it? It's well far forward in the face. But you look at her nostrils, her airways are pretty big. Now, black people do have an advantage over Caucasians. They have a better nasal cavity, they've got better nostrils. We, as Caucasians, were more narrow. Okay, so she will find it easier to breathe through her nose than a Caucasian.